Hi guys, in this video we'll discuss upon which colleges to apply. I'm a general category student, I'm a NCOBC, my Acads are this and this, so what do I do, which colleges can call me, where do I have a reasonable chart and all of that. So this video is going to be about that. So let us straight away jump into this, but just before doing that, some disclaimers. This is by all means tentative. So no information in this video is going to be like 100% accurate. It's not possible. So it's going to be a tentative video. So you can tentatively find out which box do I fall into and which colleges that I can try applying and so on. And we have categorized percentiles as different ranges. So I hope you should be able to see this in terms of percentile ranges. And what more is, we have also categorized this in terms of average, above average and exceptional, the academic criteria. So if you look at it, we have taken it into three steps. One is exceptional. What do we mean by exceptional is 10th standard and 12th standard 90 plus and 80 in terms of undergrad. And then we have something called as above average, where we say out of the three criteria, two are good, let's say 85 plus and one is okay-ish. And then the third criteria is average, where you have two okay-ish and one is average, let's say 70 plus. So these are three criteria across which this entire table is split across different percentiles. So obviously the first one, IIMs, Ahmedabad and Calcutta in the exceptional thing, north of 99. Obviously it is not north of 99, it is going to be 99.6, 99.7 plus. I hope that I don't have to tell you that distinction. So in this entire line is people who have got north of 99 with 99.6 can think about ANC, LKI probably 99.3 or 4, FMS and SJM SOM tentatively 99.2, SJM SOM is Sailesh J. Mehta School of Management, IIT Bombay. So this is IIT Bombay, so remember that. So all of these requires percentiles north of 99. So is the first set of information that we wanted to convey. Then we go on to the next percentile ranges, which is 95 to 99. Among the first set of colleges, FMS application is over. Between the colleges for 95 to 99, people with exceptional scores can think about Bangalore, Indore and Shillong. People with above average scores in terms of 10th, 12th UG can think about new IIMs, Sailesh, SPJIMR, again I guess SPJIMR applications are over by November 23, IIT Delhi as well. People with average ACADS, mildly lower sectional cutoffs and all of that, not considering sectional cutoffs, they do consider sectional cutoffs, okay-ish sectional cutoffs and all of that, can think about MDI, IISE, Bangalore and NITI. NITI is also one of the premier institutes in the country. So around 97, I guess, is the cutoff for NITI, for MDI as well. For IISE, 96, if I'm not wrong. Next is 90 to 95th percentile. Among exceptional, we have Vinod Gupta School of Management. So this is IIT Kharagpur. And then we have IIT Madras, called as Department of Management Studies, my alma mater. And then we have IIT Kanpur and IIT Roorkee. So this with 90 to 95 with like a good profile is what you call as, you can get calls from this box. And you also have baby IIMs and Delhi University Department of Financial Studies and Delhi School of Economics, where you have a 90 to 95 and you have above average ACADS, then probably you are looking at these schools. And then for someone with average ACADS and you have 90 plus, then you are looking at IMT Ghaziabad, IMI Delhi, XIM Bhubaneswar, MICA. MICA takes in through MICAT, so you still have option of writing MICAT 2, which is still open. You can still apply and write MICAT 2 as on today. And you also need a 90 plus in CAT to be eligible to be called for MICA as well. XIMB takes through ZAT also and CAT as well. IMI Delhi and IMT Ghaziabad also take with scores not north of 90 or 95. If you fall under the exceptional category, obviously the left two boxes, let's say your scores are somewhere here, then you are looking at all every other box in this is possible for you. If you are in this box, then probably you're restricted to this box and the boxes following this, and not more than this. So have that in mind. So this, for anybody who is on the right, the left boxes are applicable by default, and probably these two boxes are kind of correlated. So you have above average a 99, or you have an exceptional score with 95-99. Tentatively, there is some amount of overlap between these two. So also have that sense of, don't restrict yourself just to one specific box. There is possibility of going between boxes. Now, this is an interesting place. We have scored 85, 88, 90. You're not sure, should you apply for the exam next year? Should you apply for colleges and all of that? One piece of advice, if you want, or suggestion, you would have to think about taking one or two interviews that you can, that the college offers you this year. So definitely apply for these colleges, take up the interview, convert them, probably give us a shout in April, May. We'll also help you out in terms of, should I take up this college? Am I settling? Should I go to some other college, better college, tier one college, tier two college, all of that. We can have that chat probably during the month of April or May. And now that you've scored 85 or 90, next year, now you know what this exam is about. So you don't need to begin your preparation for CAT from day one or today. So you can always go hit your colleges that you can right now, get your convert, and then see, okay, I don't want to settle for this college, I'm going for a better college. So go for it. Right? Between 85 and 90, these are some of the colleges that we have listed down. So IRMA, Institute of Rural Management, Anand, and Goa Institute of Management, KJ Somaya, Bombay, Tapmi, Tapai Institute, and Great Lakes Institute of Management in Chennai, BIM Trichy 4, Lal Bahadur Shastri Institute of Management. These are some of the colleges that cut to the 85th to 90th percentile range, if you are looking at that. Then we have 80 to 85th percentile. This is again a tricky spot. You know that you have scored occasionally well. You are not as bad as a 60 or a 65. You know you have done reasonably okay, but you don't know which colleges will even call me. You don't know which colleges should I apply to. Then look at these colleges. You have LIBA, Layala Institute of Business Administration. You have NIRMA. And then you have IFMR from Chennai, BIMTech, Noida, and a couple of NITs like Trichy is reasonably okay. Warangal and Suratkal also have their business education schools available. Then Velinkar, Bombay, UBS, Chandigarh, FMS, BHU, and NIBM and XIME. These are some of the colleges that you should try if you're somewhere between 80 and 85th percentile. Now in this slide, we'll look at, what if I have an NCOBC reservation and my scores are this, 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 and this. So where do I stand? What are my chances? Which colleges should I apply to? And all of that. They're pretty much similar to the previous structure. Only difference is, previously it was 99 plus, now it has become 97 and above. And then there was another distinction of 95 to 99, now it has become 94 to 97. So one another line of category stops there, and then you have another category of 90 to 94. So look at this. So this is very similar. Pause the video, look at this, see where your scores fall into, and see how useful it is for you, right? So some of the pointers here are, if you have a 95, 96, 97, and you have a reasonably good profile, then you're looking at FMS, SP Jain. If you have a great profile, then Bangalore, Kozhikode, Indore, Shillong, all of these colleges you're looking at. So you have a fighting chance, and definitely go for it, go for the kill, and throw yourself out there, convert your call, and then see where it takes you, right? Likewise, if you're from 90 to 94, then you're looking at MICA, IIT Delhi, and SJM SOM, IIT Bombay. They pay exceptionally well, brilliant B school, and they need you to be as brilliant as they are. So you need exceptional profile to get into SJM SOM. And for NCOBC, probably 92 90. I've seen people convert SJM SOM with a 90 profile, 90 CAT score. If your scores are between 85 to 90, then what am I looking at? TAPMI, IIT Madras, VG SOM, NITI, New IIMs. NITI is one of the premier institutes, but their NCOBC cutoff is low. So if you have NCOBC reservation, then probably make the most out of this. Even new IIMs call, even if you have a score of 85 to 90. Likewise, if you have 80 to 85th percentile, then you are looking at Great Lakes, Liba, Irma, IIT Roorkee, IIT Kanpur, and baby IIMs. If you have something north of 80, then and a reasonable profile, you are looking at baby IIMs as well. So remember that. And one more thing to remember is, after all of this discussion, there will always be some exceptions. There will be exceptions. So some guy got into IIM Bangalore or got a call from IIM Bangalore last year at 90th percentile, 89th percentile. That is an exception. You have to live with it. That doesn't mean that you have a 92, then you have a good chance of getting a call from IIM Bangalore. There are always exceptions. So remember that an exception does not guarantee you a call. If you cross that exception, by no means you are waiting for a call because that you have a 90 and someone else got a call at 89 last year. You could have a completely different profile which the profs wanted to give a chance to. So it could be the reason. Also, what is the last cutoff that convert happened matters, not now, maybe 3 months from now. So if you have been given a call, definitely go in and do your best in terms of interviews. I guess most of your doubts and would be clarified by now. And if you still have any questions, please post them in the comments. We'll try to clear your doubts as much as we can through the comments. Best wishes, guys.